how does a person answer why something happened? And when you explain a why, you have to be in some framework that you allow something to be true. Otherwise, you're perpetually asking why. That's interesting. Well, that's my idea, that the deeper the thing is, the more interesting. Now, when you ask, for example, why two magnets repel, there are many different levels. There's a magnetic force that makes them repel, and that you're feeling that force. When you turn them the other way, they attract. There's a very analogous force, electrical force, which is the same kind of a question. So that's also very weird. But you're not at all disturbed by the fact that when you put your hand on the chair, it pushes you back. But we found out by looking at it that that's the same force, as a matter of fact. The electrical force, not magnetic exactly in that case. But it's the same electrical repulsions that are involved in keeping your finger away from the chair, because everything's made out of its electrical forces in minor and microscopic details. There's other forces involved, but it's connected to electrical forces. It turns out that the magnetic and the electric force with which I wish to explain these this repulsion in the first place is what ultimately is the deeper thing that we have to start, that we can start with, to explain many other things that looked like they were, everybody would just accept them. You know, you can't put your hand through the chair. That's taken for granted. But that you can't put your hand through the chair when looked at more closely, why it involves these same repulsive forces that appear in magnets. Interesting after all. That's my idea, that the deeper a thing is, the more interesting it is.